What's up, guys? Welcome to Political Fight Club. I'm your host, Robert Durden, and this episode is about another great thing going on in Canada, which, as you know, functions quite a bit better as a social democracy than the United States, so we have a lot more data coming out in terms of things like UBI from Canada. So this study came out from, let me find it here, I read it on Vox. It's from the Foundations for Social Change, and they're just like an entity that is like a charity, I believe, here. Yeah, in association with the University of British Columbia. So what happened here, guys, is that they gave a lump sum of $7,500 Canadian dollars to 50 homeless people in Vancouver and then studied them over the next year. It was a randomized control trial, which means that there was a control group of 60 people that were homeless that were not given any money at all. And both groups were given access to workshops and coaching in the areas of like life skills and financial planning. And the results were exactly what we expected, guys. I'm going to read it to you here. The people who received cash transfers moved into stable housing faster and saved enough money to maintain financial security over that year. They decreased spending on drugs, tobacco, and alcohol by 39% on average and increased spending on food, clothes, and rent. Quote, counter to really harmful stereotypes, we saw that people made wise financial choices, said Claire Williams, the CEO of Foundations for Social Change. The study, though small, offers a counter to the myths that people who become poor get that way because they're bad at rational decision-making and self-control and are thus intrinsically to blame for their own situation, and also that people getting free money will blow it on frivolous things or addictive substances. Studies have consistently shown that cash transfers don't increase the consumption of temptation goods. They either decrease it or have no effect. The last thing that's interesting here, guys, is that they also found that because these people were housed more quickly, that $8,100 Canadian minimum was saved per person over that year. So it was a net enormous savings to their welfare state or to their social safety net that keeps people housed that are homeless by simply giving them enough money to afford rent someplace else. So it actually saved their district a lot of money by giving them money so that they weren't a burden on, you know, the homeless shelters or whatever, where it would have cost $8,100 per person. They invested $7,500. And this was such a small-scale thing, guys. If they were to do this all over the place, imagine the money we would save, or they would save in British Columbia. So it's crazy for that reason as well. But the most important thing here, guys, is that this completely debunks that awful talking point that, A, homeless people are to blame for their situation and that they got there either being lazy or stupid or making bad decisions, and also, B, the fallacy that if you give money to homeless people, they're just going to go spend it on illicit substances. The fact of the matter is that's not the case. They don't do that. And in fact, they reduced their spending on alcohol and drugs 39%, whereas the controls group didn't at all. Now, this brings me to further ascertain, and they didn't prove this in this study, but I would assume that just the fact that they had some money in their account means that they would not necessarily need to turn to drugs or alcohol for escapism or just to help them get through their day. When you're not poor and you're not always worried and you're not constantly fighting off fight or flight, that cortisol rush of stress hormone in your system, you don't always feel the need to go and drink or do drugs to escape. So just simply giving people enough money to be stable and help them sleep at night is going to help them move away from drugs and alcohol. Now, that's not proven in here, but I would assume that that's probably part of the reason that they had such a stark difference in the lump sum group versus the not lump sum group. So it's crazy, but it's not at all surprising, guys. This has been done numerous times, and I've talked about it before on my show. I think it was in California someplace. I think it was Stockton, where they did something similar to this with a UBI and homeless people, and they got similar results, guys. When you give homeless people money, or when you help really impoverish people by giving them a UBI, a lot of times they go out and they get jobs. The vast majority of time they go out and get jobs and they get their life in order because they're not so impoverished that they actually have time to go search for a better job, or they go back to school and get training, or, you know, they have an extra day off a week because they don't have to work 6 days a week to get by, to go and search for better employment. And a lot of people, their lives improve in so many ways when you just help them out. People just need a little help, guys. And the United States is terrible at this. But now we have further evidence that defeats that bullshit, evil-ass talking point that homeless people got that way because they're lazy and because they deserved it. Not true. Most of them didn't get that way because they did something stupid or lazy. It's because something horrible happened to them. And B, they don't always go out and spend money on booze or alcohol or booze or drugs just because they get run into money. That's not true, and this further proves it. So, bravo. Canada keeps doing good things, guys. Keep fighting the good fight out there, and stick this one in your back pocket in case you ever hear these talking points, because you can absolutely just swat them down with this evidence. So, I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Keep fighting the good fight. We'll see ya.